the earlier session, we have seen about presettable counter. So presettable counter is one which can count any data. You can preset it, okay? The synchronous counter which comes in the IC, so it is always with a presettable form. Like if I want to count it from 6 to 10 or 10 to 15, anything, it can be preset by using two operations with the load capacity. That is, if PL is going to be low, then it is used for entering the data. When this parallel load capacity is going to be high, what happens when this pin is going to be high? So it enables your flip-flop, that is to enable your clock pulses and act in the synchronous mode so that it can do the flip-flop counting. Okay, so now in today's session, we will be seeing about digital clock. It is nothing but the counter application. Before proceeding to the circuit diagram, let us see a small example. Okay, suppose they are giving divide by 78 counter you design. In that case, we cannot design a single counter. Okay, in this case, you have to go in, that is 78, I can 13, 6 or 78. So, I will be using two counters, mod 13 and mod 6. Mod 6 means for every 6 states, it will count the states from, so 0 to 5. So, I am going to divide the counters and use in order to implement a 78 mod counter. The same thing is going to be applied here. In a digital clock, what are the things that is required? You need a LED segment display which should show your seconds, that is 0 to 59, and then it should show for your minutes. So 0 to 59 minutes, and then you should show the hours. Okay. Now in this case, you are going to use three things. That is, in the first row, you are going to use divide by 10 counter and divide by 6 counter. Whenever I am going to use these two, so 10 into 660, so it is going to compensate for my seconds. And here also divide by 10 and divide by 6 counter, this is going to compensate for my minutes. Next for for expressing your hour, here what am I going to do is, I am going to use a decade counter and a JK flip flop. Okay, now here what is E is nothing but your enable, and the 4 clock pulses are given directly, whereas from here RC is nothing but the ripple carry is given as a clock pulse for the next stage. Now in the second row, what we are going to have, all the datas are going to be the BCD numbers. So in the second stage, I am going to use a BCD to 7 segment decoder so that it is able, we are able to see the time in the digital clock. So you are going to use a 7 segment LED. Okay, now we will move on to the working of it. So what happens? So whenever I am going to give, that is clock frequency of 1 hertz I am going to give, and now with this mod 60 counter, I am going to count the seconds from 0 to 59. Similarly, here I will be able to count the minutes, and whatever the data, ripple carry data from the second side, it will go on to the, for counting the minutes counter. Okay, now it has to go on to the hour counter. So here what we are going to do, here only this part alone, the logic is going to be differing from this. Okay, I am going to use a BCD counter or a decade counter which is going to count from 0 to 9. Okay, initially these both should be reset. For this, what is the condition? If I am going to use a NAND gate, if I give 0, the output will be 1. Okay, so whenever the NAND gate is going to be high, then this is going to high 1 1. So this is, will be resetting the both the things. Okay, so high on the input, so will reset your flip flop as well as your counter. Okay, so from 0 to 9, so 10 states are there. What will happen? So from 0 to 9 again, it will be recycling back to 9 to 0. Okay, now whenever it is going to count this 10 states, okay, now the count is 10. 10 states are over. If I am going to click 2 more pulses, then it will move on to 11 and it will move on to 12. 1101 is 11 and 1011 is 11 and 1100 is 12. Now, what is the condition? Whenever I am going to have, I should display 12 hours. After 12, if any data is going to come, it should be resetting to 0. So, that is the concept, because I have to include here totally how much 12 hours should be there. So, in this case, whenever it reaches 13, 1101, so in that case, what happens? It has to recycle to 0. So, I am taking the QA and QB output along with, I am going to take the output from my JK flip-flop. Okay. So, whenever I am going to I am going to set or reset this flip-flop. This output data also will come here. Okay, so whenever, let us say I am going to, after 9, what happens? It will be again, it will be in a set condition. Again, you have to give the pulses and make it to be in the reset condition. So, whenever it is set, this 1 will be there, this 1 will come here. When this 1 comes here, all the inputs are 1, it will become 0. Whenever this 0 goes here, when J is 0, it will reset the flip-flop. Okay, now here whenever I am going to see the condition 1101, so whatever I am going to take, I am going to take the 1, and here I am going to take the 1. So you have here 2 inputs are there. So whenever it is going to be 2 inputs, so you are here going to have 11 is going to be the input, and initially what was the input? It was also 1. So when the input was 1, what is the output? 1 means it will give the value as 0. Okay, so here the 1 is going to be 1, the value is going to be 0. So this is going to reset my flip-flop. So whenever it is going to reset my flip-flop, what was the earlier data which is stored here? It was 1. So this 1 will come here. So it will be 0, 0, 0 and 1. So instead of going to 0, it will reset back to 1, because it has to count from 1 to 12 hours. So this concludes the concept, and here if you are going to see, here I am going to take all the inputs and I am going to give it here, whereas the same input, whatever is this data that comes here, wherever all these three datas, so it is going to be grounded. So once again, I'll just say this is for my seconds and this is for my minutes. Whenever you're going to, this is going to compute for my hour slot. So in this case, I'm going to take the data. This is going to be a BCD counter and a flip-flop you are going to use. So what you're going to do, initially it has to be reset. So reset means whenever here it is going to be 0, it will value here, it will be 1. When the output on the NAND gate is 1, it will reset the flip-flop. Okay, what is the condition of the decade counter? It goes from 0 to 9 and again 9 to 0. So in this condition, when it goes from 0 to 9 and 9 to 0, what happens? It counts 10 states. Okay, after the 10 states, it will be in the reset, it will move on to the set condition, the flip-flop. So whenever it is going to be in this, after 10, whenever 10 count is there, whenever I am going to press the 2 more clock pulses, it will come to the 12. What is the thing? 12 hours only is required. When it comes to 13, it has to reset. So at that point, I am taking the QA and QB. Okay, and whenever whatever the previous output stored is 1, whenever it is going to be given, so it will make the output as 0. When this output is 0, what will happen? It will come, when J is 0, it will reset the flip-flop. So whenever I am going to reset the flip-flop, the previous data which is stored here is set as 1, that data will come here, all other places it will be 0. Thus, after 12, instead of recycling back to 0, it comes to 1. So 1 to 12 hours you can compute. And whenever you are going to come here, the same data will come here, because only in the last MSB is required, other datas are being grounded. Thank you. With this, I conclude the digital clock. Thank you.